The urgent search continues tonight for people given food parcels containing lollies with potentially fatal amounts of methamphetamine. Police say the Rinda-brand pineapple sweets may have been distributed in grocery boxes from the Auckland City Mission over the past several weeks. And here's the big danger. Drug tests show one lolly contained approximately 3 grams of methamphetamine. A common dose to swallow is just 10 to 25 milligrams, so that single lolly holds up to 300 doses. The Drug Foundation says consuming that much meth is extremely dangerous and could result in death. Yvonne Tahana has developments.
A sweet treat for some of our most vulnerable, but now Auckland City Mission is dealing with a nightmare.
We have at least one confirmation of a family, a mother giving this to her children. Gratefully, they spat those lollies out.
That's the fear, isn't it? That's the fear that a child could die, anyone could die.
You have genuinely said the sentence that's kept me up nearly all night.
The sealed bags of lollies, appearing to be from Malaysian confectionery company Rinda, were donated and then distributed inside food parcels. Recipient called the mission yesterday at 2 p.m. to report funny-tasting lollies. Staff checked some.
One of our staff members describes it to me is that it is acrid and revolting.
And that was enough to send them for testing at the Drug Foundation. By 3 p.m, the sample was found to be a 3-gram block of meth.
This is potentially lethal for somebody who consumes the same amount.
At least 8 families have received the sweets, including one child and a teenager. 3 people have been hospitalised, but all have been discharged. Now it leaves the mission staff to contact 300 to 400 families who received the food parcels.
The advice to anyone who's consumed one is to seek medical attention.
Symptoms include chest pain, a racing heart, seizures, hypothermia, delirium, and loss of consciousness.
Police have recovered 16 so far, but are unsure how many there are in circulation.
Do you feel like it's a race against time?
We have to treat it with some urgency, and we need to round these things up as quickly as we can.
There is a potential for New Zealand that there is a lethal substance dressed up as a lolly.
Police believe the lollies have been imported.
This method puts the New Zealand public at extreme risk, and it's frightening.
Still, a thank you from the city missioner to the Kiwi who called it in.
I am very proud of them, so much so that I rang them directly last night and said that their actions had potentially saved lives in our country.
A wide-ranging police investigation codenamed Tirade is now underway as the danger remains.
So what are the next steps with this investigation, Yvonne?
Well, police have described this as frightening, Simon, and not the least because last year we had a 21-year-old, an innocent 21-year-old, Aidan Sanala, die after unwittingly drinking liquid methamphetamine. A family member of his told me this afternoon that they were sad about current events and that they were praying that no lives would be lost. Now, the challenge here for police is to get those lollies out of circulation. The wider investigation is going to include things like forensic testing and contacting international agencies like Interpol.
And you've heard from the lolly company. What did it say?
That's right. Late this afternoon, Rinda Food Industries sent us a statement, and they said that they were alerted that their products may have been misused, specifically in relation to methamphetamine, by news reports out of New Zealand. And the company wanted to make it clear that they don't condone the use of illegal drugs in their products, and that they will be cooperating with law enforcement. Finally, an immediate consequence of all of this is that the mission has had to pause a delivery of food parcels to vulnerable people as they chuck all of their resources at trying to find those 300 to 400 affected families. Simon.
Tēnā koe, Yvonne. Thank you very much.